Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. This is Sudhi and you're watching me on For Women in India. In today's video, we'll be talking about the ongoing debate on those three bills that led to Shiromani Akali Dal quitting NDA, Harsimrat Kaur Badal of the same party resigning as Union Minister in September 2020, and the ongoing farmers' protest in the country. Today's video is about the recent farm bills introduced by the government. Before we move to the bills, let us understand the background of the issue. Since independence, farmers' needs and issues have remained a major concern for governments. Back in 1960s, all over India, the state government set up large mandis which were regulated by the Agriculture Produce Market Committees or APMCs to control food trade, track and ensure food availability, and ensure fair transactions and reasonable price for the farmers. This was a democratic system with the physical auctions as the basis of price discovery. It was accompanied by minimum support price or MSP for farmers in key crops. As per the article Minimum Support Price to Farmers in India, MSP is an agricultural product price set by the Government of India to purchase directly from the farmers. This rate is to safeguard farmer to minimum profit for the harvest. If the open market has lesser price, then the cost incurred. There are around 26 commodities covered under MSP presently in India, and the APMC mandi was the mechanism through which state would procure the produce at a pre-announced price. So now, the farmers could sell their produce in APMC through licensed middlemen or arhatiyas, or they had an option of selling it to the government on MSP. But sadly, the reality is not as simple and good as it sounds. Over the years, the system deteriorated when vested interest of the middlemen in collaboration with local politicians took over. According to the government's Shanta Kumar committee, about just 14% of the paddy and wheat farmers were able to sell their produce to government procurement agencies. The report also says that even those who sold to the government got the declared MSP for about 27 to 35% of their produce. As per a report published in Al Jazeera, the Indian agriculture sector contributes nearly 15% in the country's $2.9 trillion economy, but employs about half of the country's population, that is 1.3 billion people. In the recent past, farmers have been falling into debts due to many reasons, like failure of crops or not getting appropriate prices for their produce. These reasons have led to an increase in the suicide cases by the farmers. The change in laws and policies in the agriculture sector has been long overdue. Yet when the changes are announced by the new bills, the farmers have been protesting against it non-stop. Let us look at what are these three bills and why are farmers protesting against it. The first is the Farmers Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilitation Bill. Under this bill, a farmer can sell his crops to any trader anywhere in the country. There will be no obligation to sell the crops in agriculture produce and livestock market committees or APMC mandis of their own region and district. The government is calling it as One Nation, One Market. The second is the Farmers Empowerment and Protection Agreement on Price Assurance and Farm Services. Under this bill, the farmer's interest is protected by allowing him to enter into agreement with businesses and wholesalers to sell their crops at a fixed price mutually agreed. The third is the Amendment in Essential Commodities Act 1955. Before the Essential Commodities Act was enacted in 1955, the farmers used to sell their crops to the moneylenders and businessmen who could store them in large numbers, thus engaging in black marketing. The then government enacted this act in order to curb the black marketing, but now government has amended the act and agriculture products like cereals, pulses, oil seeds, edible oils and potatoes have been removed from the act. Now comes the question, why are the farmers protesting? The first ordinance makes APMCs virtually redundant. The new private mandis would not be regulated by the government. The farmers are predicting that this is the first step towards eliminating the MSP. Although the percentage of farmers benefiting from the MSP is very low, but in this new unregulated private mandis, state bonuses on MSP and purchase and other protection will be completely lost. Instead of enhancing and expanding its procurement system that would benefit small and marginal farmers the most and ensure the protection of MSP, The government is privatizing the agriculture. The MSP should be properly implemented, and anybody who does not adhere to it should be penalized. In fact, the Maharashtra government has approved a change in law to send any trader to jail for a year for paying below the government prescribed minimum support price for a crop. A penalty of Rs 50,000 is included in the amendment proposed to the Maharashtra Agriculture Produce and Marketing Development and Regulation Act 1963. The three bills further say that farmers can have direct agreements with private companies. This kind of arrangement might seem smart at the first look, but along with numerous terms and conditions which come with it, it would be difficult for the farmer to deal with them eventually. They will end up becoming the captive of the private company. If the agreement is not fulfilled by either of the party, it will be difficult for the farmers to fight for their rights or to defend themselves in a court of law with limited protection and resources at their disposal. For instance, if the farmer gets into a disagreement with a company, it will be very difficult for the farmer to settle the case in their favor. For example, how will small farmers from rural and interior areas of the country face a company like Adani Group? Any legal liability arising from the contract will always end up detrimental for the farmers. Also, the company buying the finished crop from the farmers will now have the right to stock or hoard them, which till now was illegal. If big companies will hoard essential commodities, it would lead to rise in prices. In an interview with The Wire, P. Sainath said that it is a very clear pro-corporate intent. It may just materialize in devastating chaos in which middlemen will wring an even harder grip, because many more farmers will be deprived of the access which they have. The number of farmers stuck to private transactions without any intervention will be greater. Although the bill states that the farmers can sell their produce to whomsoever they want to and wherever or whenever they want to, but will any small farmer be able to store his finished crop for months unless and until provided some storage facilities? How will they get access to cold storage to keep their produce? How will they transport the crops? Are the APMC mandis located at a convenient distance for the farmers? How far do they have to travel to sell their crops and other produce? Are they even aware of the existence of MSPs or mandis? The farmers will bound to sell their produce at a rate which will be unsustainable for them to somebody who is ready to unscrupulously benefit from the challenges faced by them. The government should provide basic infrastructure for cold storage and transportation facilities to farmers to store their produce and get remunerative prices for it. In conclusion, we just want to say that it is fine for the government to tell the farmers to sell their produce anywhere outside APMC mandis and at whatever price they want to and whoever they want to. But the government should not let the prices of the products topple. The prices should be in accordance with the MSP. It should make sure that the private companies do not harass the farmers. The government should also provide adequate measures for facilitating transportation to them. All these reasons are enough to prove that while agriculture and its marketing need proper inspection and assessment, these bills also need to be consulted extensively again, and they should not have been passed in such a haphazard manner in the first place. What do you think should be done to address the problem of farmers? Give us your feedback in the comment section and let us know what you think about today's video.
Like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hit the bell icon to never miss an update.